Hey y'all, and welcome to the Sprinkle Factory YouTube channel where we cover everything culinary. Today we're going to be making balsamic glazed lamb chops in a pineapple boat with sweet chili rice and a pineapple Hennessy margarita. Let's get straight into it. First, we're going to start with the pineapple. Make sure you're using a sharp knife. It's going to make your job so much easier. Go ahead and cut it in half. And the next step is we're going to grab our ice cream scoop. This actually makes things so much easier for me, but you guys can use a regular spoon if that's what you have. But we're going to score the pineapple. So in the middle there, that's the core of the pineapple. So we're going to cut around the core and then around the perimeter of the pineapple. We're just going to make sure that we're cutting through, but we're not puncturing the skin. So we're getting as close as we can without actually cutting through the pineapple. Next, once you do that, what's going to make it easier is if you cut everything into cubes. So this way you can kind of remove one cube at a time instead of trying to remove the whole middle of the pineapple. It just makes your job easier. So go in with your ice cream scoop, and first we're going to remove the core. We're going to remove the core because we're going to discard it. I actually like to snack on the core, but it's completely up to you guys, but it's not going to be good for our drink. Once we get all of the core chunks out, we want to go ahead and remove as much of the pineapple flesh as we can. Put it in a bowl and put it to the side, okay? The best thing to do at this point is to put it in the freezer, and I'll tell you why in just a bit. Go ahead and cover up your pineapples, and I like to store them in the refrigerator. Just cover them up with saran wrap, and we're going to bring out the beautiful lamb chops, okay? I was literally in my feelings about the lamb chops because they were so beautiful, so of course I had a photo shoot, so that's why the cutting board is decorated. But go ahead and cut your lamb chops into little individual steaks, and of course the only seasoning you're going to need for this is the Just a Sprinkle all-purpose seasoning. Has an amazing flavor, guys. It touches on the garlic notes, the onion notes, as well as a lot of other key seasonings that's really going to turn this dish up quite a bit. For this job, I'm going to grab a heavy-duty skillet. I actually prefer cast iron because it holds the heat better and it actually evenly distributes the heat around the pan, so you don't have too many hot spots. We just want to put some butter into the pan, allow it to just slightly brown. That's going to bring out the nutty notes of the butter, and we're going to add our lamb chops. Now, for a good medium well, you probably want it about 5 to 6 minutes on both sides, but what I'm actually going to do, because it could be a little bit complicated if this is your first time, I'm going to insert a cooking chart. So if you guys want to screenshot that real quick, and then also at your local grocery store or maybe a Walmart, pick up a meat thermometer. So this way you can actually insert it and you can pick up the correct temperatures. While the lamb chops are cooking, we're going to work on our sauce. So we have a half a cup of honey, and we're going to add about a teaspoon of garlic and a half a cup of balsamic vinegar. In addition to that, and you can find this in your sauce aisle, your condiment aisle, just a half a cup of sweet chili sauce. So we're going to put all that together. We're going to give it a little sprinkle with Just a Sprinkle and allow it to cook. So mix everything in. We want to reduce this probably by half. If you reduce it by half, it's going to actually get pretty thick. But because it's such a high sugar content in this sauce with the honey and a little bit in the sweet chili sauce, we want to do that. Just have a little patience and do that on low. So once all that is reduced, it should look like this. It should be pretty thick, and it should actually coat a spoon. So once you reach this consistency, take it off the heat. It's actually going to thicken a little bit more as it cools. So this is the perfect consistency. In a separate pot, I'm going to add a chicken bouillon cube, a tablespoon of butter, and a half a cup of sweet chili sauce, you guys. We're going to bring that to a boil, and we're going to add 2 cups of rice. We're going to cover it, turn it down to low, and allow it to cook about 20 minutes. Once it's done, you can fluff it up, but all of that sweet chili and chicken bouillon flavor is in the rice as well. So each aspect of your dish is going to be completely flavorful. At the end of your searing process, which is what we're doing now, that's what we're doing to get the lamb chops nice and brown, you want to add about 2 tablespoons of butter to your pan, about 5 sprigs of thyme and a tablespoon of garlic. Let this all warm up and become floral, and it's going to have an amazing flavor. I know a lot of you guys have actually been contacting me asking if I can give you some plating tips. So let's go ahead and plate the pineapple together. It's actually super, super simple. We're going to go ahead and add the rice to the pineapple. We're going to stack it up as far as it can go without toppling over, of course. And at this time, your lamb chops should totally be cooked. So you want to pick maybe 3 to 4. It depends on your function. It depends on where you're serving this at. I don't know if maybe it could be a party or an event and you want to kind of use it as a centerpiece, or if you're serving it to a single person. So it's completely up to you guys. When it comes to plating and presentation, it's all about your creativity. Do not think too hard about it. Just let it flow and do whatever looks pretty. Next step to this, guys, is your sauce. So it's no right and no wrong way to do this. Just add as much as you want or as little as you want. And then you want to sprinkle it with some parsley. Of course, you got to dress it up for your Instagram photo. And then that's it, guys. Completely simple. But I have a surprise for you. Bonus video. Okay, so we're not going to let anything go to waste. We're going to use that pineapple that we took out of our pineapple bowls earlier, and we're going to make a pineapple Hennessy margarita. Oh my God, I'm so excited. Now, there's a difference, you guys. There's a difference between a drink and a drink. This is a drink. So we need about 2 cups of ice, you guys, the fresh pineapple. We need some Hennessy, some tequila, some fresh squeezed lime juice, some simple syrup, and some triple sec. We're going to use the triple sec, which is an orange liqueur. Everything goes in at the same time, you guys. So I'm going to add 2 cups of ice, about a cup of pineapple, probably 2 tablespoons of the lime juice, and we're going to add about 1/4 cup of the triple sec. Now, this is where the drink becomes a drink with the tequila, you guys. Now, I'm not a mixologist, so they probably will tell you use a certain amount of ounces, but I'm going to just give you the generic measurements. So I'll probably put, literally guys, I'll probably put about a cup of tequila in here, because it was a long day. I'm trying to get this video done for you guys, and I knew that after everything was complete, I was going to sit down with this drink and it was going to be amazing. So after the tequila, and yes, we're still pouring, so bear with me, we want to add the simple syrup. So the simple syrup, we're probably going to add roughly 3 tablespoons. And again, guys, I'm not a mixologist, I'm a chef. So we're just going to use the measurements that we know. So next, what's going on is the Hennessy, and we're going to add that in. It's probably about 1/2 cup. Seriously, it was a long day. So, of course, remember, this is not a drink. It's a, say with me, drink. Once we've added everything to the blender, we want to make sure that we put the lid on it, guys. That's very important. And we want to go ahead and blend it up. If your drink is too liquidy, again, it's personal preference. What thickens it up is going to be ice. So the more ice, the thicker it gets. I'm going to show you guys my garnish plate, and it's completely up to you. Again, it's your creativity. Have a little drink umbrella, some maraschino cherries, a lime, and of course, the miniature Hennessy. We're just pouring a little bit of the cherry juice at the bottom. Literally, that is just for color, more pizzazz. And then we want to go ahead and pour the frozen margarita in. And it, of course, looks so delicious. And again, put the mini Henny in. Stick everything in. Make it cute, guys. The drink is total vibes. The meal that we prepared is total vibes. Together, as my grandma would say, finger licking time. Thank you guys for watching. I love y'all. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, share with your friends, and I'll see you next time.